The last time we saw Murphy and Lucinda,
I just want to get married.
They were strolling down the sidewalk.
But it is fun.
On their way to matrimony. The couple met at Huntsville's first Seventh-day Adventist church.
I knew that I could never love another woman as much as I loved Antoinette.
Murphy's wife for 41 years.
But I can love someone as much as I loved her for who they are.
Had passed away. 4 months later, Lucinda, who divorced more than 30 years ago, moved to Huntsville.
I didn't want him to think that I was interested. I wanted him to be interested first.
Both sat in the balcony.
She never looked this way.
Nope.
Even though I was waiting, hoping she would.
They finally spoke at church.
A few months went by and I'm like, you know, he's kind of nice, you know, he's handsome and...
keep talking.
But the spark ignited during a gathering at Murphy's house.
My heart was telling me, you need to keep talking to this woman. I think I was hearing the Lord clearing his throat. That's the one.
Murphy popped the question. She said yes. They both said, I do.
I did.
We did.
Yeah.
We did it. Boy, did we do it.
As long as we both felt it.
Okay, thank you.
Murphy and Lucinda tied the knot July 29th.
I was ready to get married now. You know, we've done all of this other stuff. Let's get the ceremony on.
The bride watching her future husband through a side door.
So he didn't see me looking at him, but the minute I saw him come on, my heart skipped a beat. And I was just staring at him.
And when he saw her,
she comes around the corner and I tear up immediately.
For the first time,
she is gorgeous.
He almost lost it.
Real close. And then inside, I said, Murphy, get yourself together. Don't blow the wedding by acting like a big old crybaby. But I was close.
Walking down the aisle, Lucinda focused on Murphy.
Did you feel like you were the only two in the church?
Yes. And that's the way it felt, too, because I didn't see anybody else there. I didn't see anyone except for him.
But everyone saw the kiss.
I wasn't going to do one of them little chintzy, you know, kind of shy, too many people here. Mm-hmm. I was fixing to kiss my wife, and that's what I did. I kissed her.
It was more than a peck.
And then he kissed me.
And then at one
from
point,
one side to the other side.
Well, it's partly...
This went on for about a minute and a half.
And don't get it twisted now. The woman was kissing back, you know. This was not a one-sided affair.
It takes two.
It takes two. Mm-hmm. And at one point, I felt her hand on the back of my head. I said, oh, it's on now.
The newlyweds got lost in the moment.
It just was that good, Trey. That's all it was. What else you want me to say? The kiss was just that good.
And what better way to end their love story than with a kiss?
You ain't got enough film. So I'm not going to even do that to you.
Actually, we had 45 minutes of recording time left.
Ain't enough, bro. Trust me, it ain't enough.
Lucinda was ready.
Well, we'll give him a short version.
Okay.
All right.
And remember, kids might be watching.
Oh, okay.
That's love.
It's a good thing you mentioned the children, buddy, because we were fixing to lose it again.
In Madison.
I'm glad you mentioned the kiddies.
Jerry Hayes.
Oh, my goodness.
WHNT News 19.